This is like something out of a Hollywood movie. Back and forth, a slugfest. This is guts and intestinal fortitude personified. Both men letting it all hang out. They're pulling out all the stops. What more have they got left in the tank? These two incredible martial artists. They're giving it their all.
Final instructions from Yuji Shimada. Three rounds of action, but nobody thinks it'll go that far. Miyado says second round leg lock.
Ready, go!
Pongsiri Mitsatit, first round knockout, overhand right. The Muay Thai champion of Northern Thailand in the black trunks. On the right of screen. Both men just tipping their feet in the water early here. Miyado said he's happy to stand and trade with Pongsiri Mitsatit.
Both these guys have massive records in their respective striking arts. It'll be very interesting to see how these two engage each other and really just kind of test the waters.
Miyado was wary of keeping out of the clinch game of Mitsatit, but staying standing in a kickboxing range. Not necessarily in a Muay Thai range. Uppercut misses the target, almost took out the ring lights.
Catches the flying knee and immediately gets into that clinch, so I know that's what he said he doesn't want to do, but he's got to create a little bit of distance. Use that jab and get moving around. He doesn't want to stand there like a stationary target.
Pongsiri Mitsatit. 7 out of 8 first round wins.
Mitsatit loves the knees. He likes to fly in with the knees. And immediately as Miyado shoots in, he lands one. But now he gets put on his back. This is unfamiliar territory for Mitsatit. He goes for that heel hook you were speaking about, Michael.
Back to their feet. Beautiful combination from Miyado. Got off some power salvo. Miyado with confidence in the opening 90 seconds. Threads those long arms. Hoping to land to the jaw of Mitsatit. Outside leg kick. Overhand right from Pongsiri Mitsatit. Put for the Muay Thai clinch of the high knee.
I like the dirty boxing of Miyado, but he's got to be careful inside that clinch because when he starts swinging wildly with those punches, he's leaving himself perfectly open for a knee.
Miyado keeping his distance at the moment. Wild bolo punch and a short right hand. Smack bang on the jaw. Threads out the left. Mitsatit ties him up, tries to pull the head down. Tried to go for the headache maker. Spinning back fist from Miyado. And the crowd appreciating the beautiful technique we're seeing in the striking match.
Both these guys are very relaxed and they're kind of letting their skills really be showcased. Nice takedown from Miyado to end up in the guard of Mitsatit.
Halfway through the opening round, set for 3.
The triangle. Miyado's trying to shrug it off, past the guard.
Mitsatit does have one submission, a 100% finishing right.
Setting up that heel hook again.
Nice up kick and Miyado walks away. Beautiful right hand there from Mitsatit. Miyado on the outside now. Mitsatit controlling center cage. Jump walking right hand from the Thai. Short knee looks for the liver. Miyado takes him down inside the guard here of the Thai.
Again, big takedown from Miyado to control the top position. Looks like he's got a little bit of damage going on there, but Mitsatit's landing those short elbows.
Those elbows of Mitsatit are razor sharp. Miyado postures up now. Butterfly hook, 1 foot on hip from Mitsatit. Miyado trying to drop an elbow of his own.
Okay.
Again, short elbows there landed by Mitsatit. Miyado's trying to bury his head into the chest, but it's also leaving him available for those short elbows.
Chance for Mitsatit to get back to his feet. And Miyado allows him to do so.
Hands up. Hands up.
Intriguing opening round with 1 minute 15 remaining. Early on, it was Pongsiri Mitsatit who seemed to have the momentum on his side with the striking. But over the last minute or so, we've seen Miyado come on strongly. Wherever you're watching in 128 countries around the world broadcast to potentially over 1 billion people. We hope you're enjoying Hero's Dream live from Yangon, Myanmar. in front of a sellout audience. And that said, Mitch, in all my career commentating on combat sports, I have never seen nor heard an audience like we have here in Yangon. This place is electrifying.
Yangon are some serious martial arts fans. They love it. They thrive in it. And if you have not been to a ONE Championship event, you have got to come see this thing live.
Back underway. Mitsatit trying to stay in the center of the cage. They clinch up. Good short right hook, then fades away to Miado. Spinning back fist, he telegraphed it. Mitsatit looks for the body tuck under from Miado. Can he affect the takedown? No.
Takedown defense by Mitsatit to kind of save himself from that single leg. Start pushing the head out and slide that leg out.
Very evasive from the 21-year-old Pongsiri Mitsatit from Chiang Mai, Thailand. Edges forward, flat-footed, overhand right from Miyamoto. Nowhere near the target.
Miyamoto's got to start disguising his strikes a little bit better. He's really just opening up with these one big shots, like that spinning back fist, like that big right hand. Throw that jab out there, set something up. Give him something else to look at. Maybe some leg kicks. Jab, leg kick. Start putting together some combinations.
Nice counter right hand. Doubles up in it. Second one to the jaw there from Mitsatit. The Thai hopes for a takedown. Throws a knee to the midsection. Doubles up. There's a third. Good ending to the round there from Pongsiri Mitsatit.
Mitsatit so strong in that clinch. Miyado did land some takedowns, though, and did control the top position. Here he is going for that Ashigari, where he's attempting a leg lock, but Mitsatit rolls back out. So this is the round where he said he was going to get that leg lock, but we'll see. Look at this close boxing range then, where Mitsatit gets it nice and tight. Goes in for the clinch, but Miyado just runs right through it to land another takedown. Interesting first round from both these two strikers.
Miyado predicted a second round leg lock victory. Pongsiri Mitsatit predicted a first round knockout with the overhand right. You can also see a little hematoma just popping up over the left eye there of Pongsiri Mitsatit. Nothing though to be concerned about as we roll into the second set for three. Two athletes with a high finishing rate. Indeed, Mitsatit 100%.
Stay corner.
8-0. He has finished everybody. Yuji Shimada gets us back underway. Let's see if Miyado can use his length here. Very long legs, very long arms. Just backs off. Got to watch the overhand right here of Mitsatit. There's a bit of a scooping right followed by a short left, and Miyado says he didn't hurt me. Miyado tries for an overhand right of his own. Outside leg kick, right hand over there from Mitsatit. Just a little half grin on the face here of Pongsiri Mitsatit. Really enjoying himself out there, Mitch.
They call him the smiling assassin for a reason. He's always got that grin on his face. He enjoys his time inside the cage, relishes this moment. Diving takedown from Miyado as he presses Mitsatit up against the cage.
Nice tie clinch and knees here. Domination in the clinch from Mitsatit. Miyado knew that that was one of the main weapons of Pongsiri, the Muay Thai clinch and knees.
So strong in that clinch, Michael, and you can see Miyado just kind of runs away from it, but he backs up away from it, so he's got to be careful not to drop his hands because the smiling assassin might come in with one of those big flying knees.
Miyado did tell us yesterday he'd try to counter Mitsatit's kicks and then look for the takedown. But he feels that he's okay so long as he stays in this sort of kickboxing range. Looping left hand from Miyado, telegraphing.
But he's trying to close the distance by running in with these big punches, and he's not really landing or really closing the distance. So, and you can see Pongsiri Mitsatit kind of waving his head at him like he got nothing on him.
A little bit of showboating there from Pongsiri, just trying to sucker in Miyado. He wants Miyado to come into range. Tries to launch into range for a flying knee there. young gun.
Reach,
and referee Yuji Shimada wants to see more action. So too does the sellout crowd here in Yangon. High kick from Pongsiri. Now they're toe to toe. Pongsiri trying to walk down Miyato. Miyato backs away. Good little sidestep from Pongsiri. Cuts off the cage. Miyato backs up against the fence here.
Just spun Miyato around to end up in side control. Now, Miyato tried to go for that leg lock, or they tried to go for a single leg, but got pushed away by Mitsatit. Now we're starting to see that forward pressure of Mitsatit. Miyato's got to be careful because his back's up against the cage now.
Pongsiri Mitsatit, who made his debut in the cage in 2014. Made his one championship debut in May of last year. A fantastic knockout over in Bangkok, followed that up with a win over a Wushu champion Robin Catalan in March this year, who he knocked out in 15 seconds remaining in the first round. And he keep the momentum going here tonight with a knockout over Miyato.
See Mitsatit just cutting off the angles every time Miyato starts to move to the right. You can see Mitsatit slide to the left. He really put everything he had into that first round, and now Mitsatit's picking him apart. He's eating up that leg, too.
That yellow card will either ignite Miyato or deflate him even more. He is tired. And can Mitsatit capitalize? Miyato backs up yet again. Mitsatit may be setting the right hand. Double leg from Miyato. He's trying to change the game plan. He's trying to change the contest, but he's been fully mounted now.
Easy. Stop. See him point to the eye. It looked like he just had enough. Something could have been wrong. That's the what he was. Look at that way he ate up that leg. Beautiful leg kick. That had to hurt. Spun him around. Here's the finish. Once Mitsatit got on top and he started to let a little bit go, it was a verbal submission. Miyato had nothing left and was forced to give up.
Sensational from Pongsiri Mitsatit.
See, I feel something wrong with his Michael. I think something was wrong with his eye. He kind of winced when he hit him with that elbow, and that could have been it.
You feel that Mitsatit, maybe at the moment in his career, overshadowed by some of the bigger Thai stars here at one championship, like Shannon Wirachai or Dech Damrong. But after a performance like that, he is on the radar.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 23 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of verbal tap out, Pongsiri Mitsatit!
By way of verbal tap out, Pongsiri, the smiling assassin Mitsatit, maintains his undefeated record.
With Yuji Shimada in charge, it's both men now in the ring with one fight experience in one championship. Catalan looking to get back on that winning side of things. Mitsatit hoping to remain undefeated. Round one. And with a touch of gloves, both fighters engage, and immediately a right round kick there from Mitsatit, sitting on the outside so far, Mitch.
Yeah, Catalan looks really relaxed. Mitsatit has just a little bit more experience when it comes to competitive mixed martial arts, and he looks very comfortable in front of his hometown here in Thailand. So we're gonna expecting to see a lot of good things from Mitsatit. His coaches has been speaking this guy high his praises because he's just such a hard worker. Every single day he's improving and getting better and learning all aspects of mixed martial arts.
And the talk of the locker room is that over time he's looked to not only use his Muay Thai base, but set up that striking with a little bit more intelligence and ring awareness for MMA.
Yeah, you know, you can see his guard is a bit high. He's got that Muay Thai stance.
you know, nice and relaxed, consistently moving forward. Both these fighters have their shorts hitched up a little bit, so you can see definitely the Muay Thai influence from both these guys. Catalan looks to be just kind of waiting. He knows how dangerous Mitsatit is, and he just kind of looks like he's just sort of picking his shots, waiting for the right time to unload.
And possibly trying to pull the counter there as Catalan steps in off that inside low kick to an overhand right. But right now, it would seem to me that Mitsatit more capable in controlling the distance. And there's the shot from Catalan into the clinch.
I like how he set that up with a little bit of that lead leg kick and shot right in for the clinch. Didn't really go for the double leg, but just wanted to initiate and really close the distance from that spacing that he was kind of giving Mitsatit, allowing him to relax a little bit. But now he's into the clinch, so let's see what Mitsatit's like into the clinch.
And always an interesting point in a Muay Thai contest is when both athletes clinch up for the first time. 50-50 here so far, and you can see Catalan wants to stay on this position. He would not want his back up to the mesh, Mitch.
Yeah, he's trying. Now he's got both underhooks where he has both arms underneath the arms of Mitsatit, which is, you know, now he's lost that. Mitsatit goes back into the plum, the tie clinch there, and Catalan immediately transitions down to a single leg. Tries to step over for a head and arm throw, and he lands it, but Mitsatit ends up on top.
Incredible work there by Mitsatit, and his base is so strong for MMA, not only with the wrestling he's been working on, but certainly the grappling skills, those underrated skills from Muay Thai. Mitsatit thinking about maybe catching a leg drag here. Catalan in some early trouble, Mitch.
Yeah, he looks to be okay. He looks comfortable on the ground. That's a big right hand thrown by Mitsatit. So he's just kind of setting that up. He's got to be careful he doesn't jump into an up kick, though. Trying to pass the guard, you know, controlling the leg very well.
And good moves here from Mitsatit. So certainly the results of that hard work, and a big right hand again lands. Catalan covering up, though, avoiding the worst of it so far, Mitch.
I like how he throws the leg off to the side and then steps over with the right hand. So he evades the possible up kick while landing a big right hand of his own. I'm surprised Catalan's letting him control that leg the way that he's doing, because he seems to have a very good grip on his right foot there. See how he throws that leg and drops that big hand again?
And again, Mitsatit goes 2-on-1 on the leg to the overhand. Catalan trying to fight for a leg. Mitsatit steps away. Hammer fist from Mitsatit. Man, what an incredible start. And the Thai crowd, Mitch, loving it so far.
Yeah, they're definitely cheering on their hometown boy. Now Catalan's trying to lace under it, but Mitsatit actually stepped on his hand as Catalan was trying to defend there. You can see him, you know, trying to tangle up the legs a little bit, but Mitsatit's doing a good job of really just defending and countering quite well. And Yuji Shimada's had enough, and he wants them back up on their feet.
And an applause from the extremely well-educated crowd here in attendance tonight at the Impact Arena. Both fighters certainly know what's at stake thus far, and a huge right again lands for Mitsatit. Catalan definitely wants to stay out of the clincher off his back here.
Yeah, he gets into the clinch. Mitsatit jumped in with a flying knee, just kind of caught the body a little bit of Catalan. That seems to be his most successful move, is that head and arm throw to end up on top. He's just not able to control Mitsatit because he's so squirrely on the ground.
And this was one of the problems that I was seeing in the clinch. It's the control of the Thai plum as the knees come into the midsection. Yuji Shimada watching carefully here. Could this be it? Catalan looks in trouble here, Mitch. Catalan falls over and a huge right hand. He turns away and that's the end.
That was beautiful. The knees from the clinch did the damage. Catalan did not like that. And then he just jumped in with a big right hand. Let's take a look at some of that action where he was able to secure another win and remain undefeated. Here, Catalan went in for that head and arm throw. He wasn't happy with the clinch, but then Mitsatit just unloaded him, a barrage of knees. And you can see how much trouble Catalan was in when he started to defend and drop the knees down, but Mitsatit did not let up and just uncorked on him. And it was just a matter of time before Catalan went down right about there. And then Mitsatit just puts the icing on the cake with some big right hands, and Yuji Shimada is forced to jump in and save the day. What a fight, Chris.
Incredible fight, and sticking with the traditions of Muay Thai. Once he had him, he never let him off the hook. Mitsatit victorious. An incredible victory here. The crowd loving it. Here's Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 4 minutes and 45 seconds in the first round. For your winner by way of referee stoppage due to strikes from the red corner, Pongsiri Mitsatit!
So the smiling assassin, Pongsiri Mitsatit, gets another win and makes it 8-0. The 20-year-old, a very bright future indeed.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.